Hello everybody, good morning. I am Pradeepta Kumar. So guys, this is the tutorial number 4 of Docker Swarm tutorial series. On today's session, we'll learn how to enable graphical user interface for Docker Swarm cluster. So guys, on last sessions, we have already learned how to manage a Docker volume, how to manage services in Docker Swarm cluster. So guys, video has been uploaded, so you can browse to Docker and Docker Swarm playlist. You can watch that video also. So guys, if you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technology, different DevOps tool, VMware administration, Linux administration, and many more latest technology. So guys, in order to enable the graphical user interface for Docker Swarm cluster, so we are using Portainer. So Portainer is a lightweight management user interface which allow you to easily manage your Docker host or Docker Swarm cluster. So Portainer is meant to be as simple to deploy as it is to use. So it consists of a single container that can run on any Docker engine. So in this session, what we are going to do, so we'll deploy a container, Portainer container, so which will enable your GUI. So Portainer allow you to manage your Docker stack, container, images, volumes, networks, and more. That means whatever things we are doing from the Docker Swarm CLI, so this can be achieved through the Docker Swarm GUI, okay, using the Portainer management UI. So let's get started how to implement. So guys, this is our implementation plan. There is two step process. One step, we need to create a volume, then we'll create a container. So docker run hyphen d hyphen p, this is the port number we are going to open, and this is the Portainer is the container name. This is, I have added the restart policies, okay, and you know, we are mapping our, you know, volume to the container, okay. So this is the two step process. So guys, and these are the two, you know, node in the Docker Swarm cluster. So if I'll give docker node ls, so this is the you know, so node 6 is my master node and node 4 is the worker node, okay. So let me execute the first step, copy paste, okay. Now volume got created. Now we'll create the container. Okay, so this is the image name, Portainer hyphen Portainer. So I have already downloaded this image, or else if it is not available in the local Docker host, then it will pull from the you know, the Docker hub. Okay, so now if you can see, if I docker ps, so that container got created and it is listening on the port number 9000. So let's go to the browser. So let me host name hyphen i, so this is my IP address of my server. So let me paste, and port number is 9000, okay. So you can see, so this is the interface. So it is asking to set the password, okay. So I will give some password, okay, create user. Okay, now it is asking connect Portainer to be Docker environment. If you want to manage the local Docker environment, or manage a remote Docker environment, or connect to a Portainer agent, or connect to a Microsoft Azure SCI. So in my case, I am going with the local, okay, then connect. Okay, now you can see this is the you know, the graphical user interface for the Docker Swarm cluster, okay. So if you can see here, if I click here, so it is showing currently there is three containers running, and six images, five networks, five volumes. Okay, so if I click on three containers, so you know, there is two stopped container, one is running, which is Portainer. Okay, from the whatever thing, suppose I'll give here docker ps hyphen a, okay. If you can see here, there is three container is running, okay. One is Portainer, this is a second, third this, okay. So only op is one container, Portainer containers, other two are in stop state. So same thing we are able to see from here, okay. So if I'll go to click on dashboard, then also networks. If you can see, there is a bridge, Docker gateway bridge, host, ingress, none. Okay, so if I I can get the same information, Docker network ls. So the same information we are getting from CLI as well as from the GLI GUI. Okay, so you can click on add network, you can create, you can delete the network, everything you can do. Suppose I want to delete the network, I can click on select the network and remove. Okay, and also if I'll go to dashboard, okay, as of now there is no services created. If you want to create any services, you can create. These are the images available. So what are things you are able to do operation from the CLI, same thing can be done from the Portainer GUI. Okay, so guys, in your lab, you can implement that and you can use. Okay, so guys, stay tuned for next videos. Thank you very much. Have a great day.